Welcome back to the Spokes Show. I'm your host, Matt Smith. Shaken, not stirred. Always here somewhere, lurking in the dark. It's been a while. It's been a while since the last podcast. And, you know, getting a house, moving in, getting set up, takes a lot longer than you think. And a lot of your side projects can kind of get put on hold because of that. So it's a little tricky. And, you know, It's been a while since my last episode. Shout out to Tasha. You know, she shared her story and it was really great. And I'm so stoked that we were able to put that out there. And I look forward to having more guests on soon. But for now, I just wanted to talk about how fleeting BMX is. And what I mean by that is it is so easy to drop this shit like a bad habit. Like straight up. Not even trying, bad habit. It's weird like that, you know? It doesn't even make sense. Because you spend so much of your life trying to learn the basics of bike riding, and then things come along and you can just drop it like it was fucking groceries. You can just stop riding and move on with shit so easily. And the reason I'm thinking about it, or it's on the top of my mind, is that, you know, I moved into a new house, got a house, stoked, big old backyard, but whatever. But haven't been riding that much at all, and a lot of it came down to either it was too hot out, or it was raining, or I have higher priority projects to work on, like, oh, we gotta get this part straightened out to the house, this, that, and the other thing. And before you know it, you haven't ridden in a month. You haven't ridden in 2 months. And then now, doing 180s feels like shit. Your whole bike feels like ass. Going to the skate park and doing your bread and butter basics feels like the hardest thing ever. And you're landing like one out of every five. And it's kind of discouraging. And I totally get it. I totally get why people fucking drop off and stop riding. It's so easy. Your muscles atrophy, and then that's pretty much it. If you're not cognizant of taking care of yourself or staying within physical activity in general, this shit will straight up vanish out from underneath you. I mean, yeah, you'll 9 times out of 10, you'll probably have, like, you know, your shit memorized to some degree if you've been riding for a while. But man, it is so, I caught myself feeling like, man, it's easier to quit right now than it is to kind of get back on the horse. And that's a feeling I never want to have, honestly. I hope I never get that feeling again. But it happened, it's there, and it's part of, you know, part of the journey. And I'm sure other people have done it. And I'm also, you know, part of the reason I started this podcast was to be able to talk to people about this kind of shit. People who have quit, why they quit, why they're okay with their decisions, and because it is okay. Or, you know, people who quit, came back. My buddy Josh, he's texting me right now. He, I think he quit riding for like 10 years, maybe. I don't know. But, you know, shout out to Josh Kurtz. He was always better at bike riding than I was. Always. Extremely skilled, and, you know, dude could hang five while blackout drunk. I'm not trying to say anything disparaging to any future employers or whatever. Motherfucker could hang five. Give, you know, sobriety test that. So, you know, and him texting me gets me so jazzed up to see people, you know, see him getting back into it, getting excited. You know, he's looking for physical activity. He's not looking to get sponsored. And that's exactly where I'm at with it. I've been in BMX for so long that I've gone through like this salty, self-grandizing, whatever you want to call it, bullshit. I've gone through the salty BMXer stage at least twice. You know, like, once you've, like, been in riding for, like, 4 or 5 years, you feel like you are, like, in it. You are just in. And then, you know, once you're in for 10 years, you feel like you're in it. And then you're in for 15 years, and you're like, I'm in it. You know, and waves come, waves go, and you start to feel like you're on the tail end of things, and all of a sudden you feel washed up, and now you're just some schmo trying to do 180s just like a hobbyist anywhere else. And a lot of that dissonance, a lot of that frustration, I think, that we get is from the hobbyist versus lifestyle dichotomy. Shout out to Challenger. There's an article in there that talked about hobbies, the death of hobbies, and that shit. And it really got me thinking about how that's kind of where the divide is in BMX. It's not old versus young. It's more like lifestylers versus hobbyists, you know? Because I think a lot of us, especially us, like, I don't know what you'd want to call it, people who have been riding 10 plus years, got into it because we wanted something to belong to. Nowadays, kids can belong to a bunch of different tribes, you know? A kid could have like a video game group that he hangs out with, and then a kendama group, and then a fucking rap group, you know, whatever, an IPA group, whatever. I'm just saying, like, the options for things to for kids to get into, for everybody to get into, is so much wider now. And BMX is definitely fleeting, so it's really important that if you do care about it, to try and hold on to it if you care about it. You know, I as much as I've fallen off and not rode while I've gotten this house with Leah, which is fucking a dream come true, as much as I've fallen off, I've still been doing my yoga, which, you know, it's very basic and crude yoga, but I've gotten to the point now where if I'm walking around during the day and I kind of feel a little out of shape, a little, like everything just kind of feels weird, wonky, like your back kind of aches and in a weird way, and feels like you're kind of like not straightened out in your spine, it's because I didn't do yoga that day or didn't do it that morning. So, you know, yoga is kind of important, and I'm happy that I'm at least doing that. And I think getting back on the horse more, riding more, now that we're kind of settling down, is gonna, on top of the yoga, is gonna actually create a better, you know, a better starting position than what I had when I was younger, honestly. I mean, I'm not really trying to prove anything. I'm not really trying to do any dead man shit. I'm just trying to do what I can do, you know? And that's all we can all ask for of ourselves. And so, you know, like, BMX is definitely fleeting. And before, you know, you blink an eye and your youth is gone. You blink an eye and all the people you looked up to are gone. It's a little scary. And I kind of just wanted to make it a point to say that BMX is fleeting, and hold on to it and do whatever you got to get on two wheels. I'm not talking about getting on your bike and going to a parking lot and having group therapy with another fucking guy. Come on, man. You got to ride your bike. Like, literally, you got to pedal. And after my recent knee injury, it is so much harder to just get on my bike and pedal, because if I try to pedal a little too hard, I get like this ache in my knee, and it's like a weird pain where it's like you have no gas left. Your knee is now gasless for the rest of the day. And I don't know what's wrong with it. Got to get it checked out. Part of the reason I started this podcast was so I could kind of like keep tabs on my physical shit and report back, because I want to pay it forward. This is my way of paying it forward to the BMX community in any way I can. I want to keep the conversation going. I want to open up the dialogue to tips and tricks of keeping the rubber side down and keeping everybody together, you know. And, you know, not everybody's going to agree with everybody on top of everything. So BMX is fleeting. Do what you can to keep a hold of it. Go pedal around the block. Go do a 180. Keep those knees going. Because if you don't, the rust is a-coming. And you don't want that. So, you know, hit up your friends you haven't heard of in a while. ask them how they're doing, ask them if they're interested in riding bikes again, help a buddy out who's reached out to you for a pair of cranks or some shit, you know, and just keep tabs on your friends, man. Don't let them fall off. And you know, shout out to everybody that's fucking been a part of this podcast, past or present, you know. Scott Marceau just recently dropped his AAngles video, which, you know, he talked about when he came on the pod. That shit, I am so excited for it. I don't know why. Maybe it's just like the titling of the little thumbnails I saw on Instagram, but it made me think of like a Quentin Tarantino film, which I don't know why. It just kind of got me jazzed up because it's refreshing. Let's put it that way. It's refreshing because it's not even nowadays. It's been for like the past while. I mean, borderline ever since props was gone, everything is now brand, team. It's either a brand edit, a team edit, or a solo edit. And that's it. So the only time you see this motherfucker is when he's either by himself, center of attention, or being paid to hang out with this guy and that guy. Which is fine. It's fine and dandy. You know, all aspects have to exist. But it is so refreshing to see this AAngles video come out because it's a bunch of different people, you know, who have a common fabric of Scott. And, you know, Scott cares about BMX and he cares about how it looks. So I'm super excited to see how it comes out. Just ordered it from him. DM him at Scott Marceau. I'll leave a link in the show notes. And also shout out to Reiner and Angus who dropped their web video, Bepiscrawdad, which I'm looking forward to talking to them about their video and how it came along and everything that went through went into it. I'm excited about that. I'm excited that Reiner finally put it together. I'm excited to see Angus finally have a video part because honestly, both of those dudes crush it. And it's nice to see riding put into a longer format and presented out there. And thing is you might have heard of this. You might have heard of this video. You might not have watched it. That's what I mean by BMX is fleeting. Like, you see it on Instagram, it's gone. You see a post about it, it's gone. You know, somebody like me, when I post on Instagram, I feel weird, like I'm annoying people if I post about something more than once. I'm like, fuck, everybody already saw this. Like, they're going to get annoyed. But, you know, you got to push that out of your head a little bit and understand that not everybody saw everything and we're all just clawing at the walls as it's running past us, honestly. So yeah, BMX is fleeting. Get on your bike, go ride, do some stretches, and feel good about it. That's my message, and I look forward to having some guests on soon.